Sounds bomb, plenty gone, a lot of innocent lives. Pentagon, I feel like Nas, I'm surviving the times. Send this letter to the president, cause I'm asking them why. We gotta live and suffer, the good die young, and the bad die old. The shorties holding their guns, ain't no jobs in the hood, so we up in the trap. You either got a wicked jump shot, or fucking with rap. Brother snitching, bootleg politicians, no pasta pissing. Another body missing, EMS probably you get him. Brothers locked in the system, rappers make it, we diss them. Here at James Shuler Memorial Boxing Gym in tough West Philadelphia, the sound of gloves hitting pads reminds you this is a fighting town. Here, one of the city's finest trains. They call him the Hammer. With hard work and dedication, ain't too many days off for one of boxing's best. Rigorous training is just a way of life.
Here is the official time, 37 seconds of round number 6. Your winner by way of technical knockout and still the NABF lightweight champion, Hammerin Pink Lundy!
Attending John Bartram High School in Philadelphia, Henry Lundy was a standout football player. Growing up in gritty South Philadelphia, he knew life would always be a fight. Amassing a 65-5 amateur record, Lundy was ready to take his quantum leap.
So when did you first meet him?
He was a little kid, really. I'm really the first started boxing.
Okay.
He was with a guy, a good friend of mine, named Lee.
Okay.
He's a little boy. I've been seeing him periodically, throughout his boxing career. Train like we always train, keep training, and really be looking for that world title. We're looking for something like that. But I think he can, you know, win that. He's the guy, if anybody's going to win it, I'll say he's the guy. It is affected, you know, in all our hearts. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Because, you know, Joe Brees, Frazier is like sort of your idol. Mm-hmm. And quite naturally, that is going to affect us. I mean, it especially once, you know, I knew it affects us for a while, but we got to do what we do to make him proud of us. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So, I mean, we only doing what he would kind of like want us to. You know, actually, Joe Frazier was rewarded just like us.
Yeah.
Just like us. You know, he comes to rumble. I mean, he turns down no fights. No fights. Anybody, I don't care what their record is, how many knockouts they got, turned down no fights. Go in the fights as the underdog, you know what I mean, to the public, not to me.
Yeah.
And come out victorious every time. Even if you got to get up. You know?
Hey.
That's a real fighter, right? Like,
smoking jokes.
Smoking jokers go on and on.
Okay, okay.
Trev Munroe, play to win the NC. Nah, I do, man. Head to the gym with the pride of Philly. You know what I mean? Got the NBF champ. Hammering Hank Lundy.
It's good, yo. It's good.
Okay, okay. Yo, it's an honor. It's a pleasure. You know, I've been watching you for the last few years. Man. You as slick as they come, bro.
Appreciate it. You know, as you can see, you know, still got the gloves on. We're putting in the work, the hard work, the dedication. Like I said a couple minutes ago, hard work be talented, if talent don't work hard. We got all the talent in the world, but you gotta put in that hard work,
right?
So let me ask you this, let's start right quick. How did you start with it? Well, you know, I was a big football star. I played for John Barch, I was a running back, cornerback, outside linebacker. I never came off the field. And you know, my last year, I got into a little scuffle. Well, actually, it was a Jamaican, you know what I mean? And you know, and that fight, it was crazy because that TV right there in boxing, you gotta outthink your opponent. Well, being as though this was my start coming to the gym, whatever, like, the guy was kicking. And I didn't know what to do, you know what I mean? My leg got numb, so I had to think. I said, man, this motherfucker might kick my leg off. So, you know what I mean? And Roy in Olympics, he threw an uppercut, and then the guy looked at Cordy. I threw a jab out to the side, and he actually looked at it. I hit him with a straight left hand and knocked him out. I actually had football practice that same day. I ran home to my uncle. I said, yo, I just knocked this guy out cold. And ever since that, I've been in the gym.
There you go.
Secondly, what would you say motivates? Oh, man.
To train and do all the hard work.
You know what? My daughters, my son, you know, being as though it's getting tough and it's getting rough out here. You know? By me coming in here, getting in the ring, putting my life on the line, it don't matter. When it comes down to my kids, you know what I mean, I sacrifice it all. Like, I'm pulled in a 10-round fight with a broken jaw twice, you know what I mean? So, with them on my man, like they say, I can do all things with Christ and strengthen them. With them on my mind, too, you know what I mean? The sky's the limit. I'm gonna walk through hell, I gotta walk through hell for my daughters.
I feel that.
You know what I mean, for my kids, you know what I mean?
Yeah. I respect that.
Now, what would you say, was the toughest fight to date? Oh man, actually, I have to give it to you hands down. Who was it? Lopez, Patrick Lopez. You know, with him, I saw that fight. Like, that guy, man, I hit him with the kitchen sink, put him down, but he kept on coming. He's a bigger guy, coming down from a different weight class, and he had something to prove. It just went him in there trying to fight to survive and get a paycheck. He had something to prove. And actually, I mean, that was a tough fight for me. Because in that fight, you know, we had to, it ain't just about, you know, I mean, bombing somebody out. You gotta outthink the next guy. That's what we did. We showed everybody that we can follow a game plan, we can stick to it. And when we get a guy like that in front of him, we always gonna come out on top. I mean, you stick to the game plan.
I've been seeing him fight for the last few years, and I gotta say, hands down, and this ain't because you here in front of me, Cash, you one of the slickest boxers, man. Like, every fight I've seen you in, you outclassed every fighter, man.
Well, you know what?
It's a good thing. Yeah, to the strategy.
Exactly, but you know, it all comes with, I mean, staying in the gym, and you just can't have one fight and just take off. You gotta come in the gym and work on different things. Like with Sloan Harrison, what we do, we come in the gym, we work on different techniques. And the things you think about, you know what I mean, in a fight, you don't even worry about in the gym, it shows up in the fight. I mean, so it's just hard work and strategy and believing and trusting to your corner, you know what I mean? And when you got that in there, the sky's the limit. You just go out there and do what you got to do.
I hear that.
Before we go, what do you see yourself moving forward? I know you're looking for that world title, yes. But you're going to stay at 135, 140? Well, you know, right now, it's like, you know, with me, I don't care. And I got a reputation, we fight anybody, anytime, any place, anywhere. And that's me, you know what I mean? I don't care, but I'm going to campaign at 35 so I win the world title. Then I go back up to 140. I was rated number 8 in the world at 140, so there's nothing for me to jump back up to 140. Like, anybody out there, 135, 140, let's get it. You know what I mean? You know, don't run a duck with nobody. You know what I mean? Number 5 in the world, let's get it. Hammer and hammer. First. What can I say? Before we go, what would you say to your fans and your followers out there? What's something about Hammer and Hammer that the people out there might not know? Well, y'all know I stay in the gym working, but I'm a loving father, you know what I mean? Hard work, well, y'all already know that because I always put it out there. But you know, with me, I keep it real and I keep it 100. And you know, I got like little blogs coming up and everything, and I let y'all in on my life. It's not like Hammer and Hank not stuck up and none of that. You know what I mean? I'm a real guy, you know what I mean?
Real talk.
Fans, I mean, even on Facebook, Twitter, they ask me questions, I reach out to them. And that's what some of us boxers, I mean, that's professional, need to do to get back. You know what I mean? And that's what I do.
This play to win EMT, so I give you the forum. Is there anybody that you're looking to fight that's on the radar?
Oh man, listen, you shouldn't have done that. You don't have to go for that.
Hey,
listen, I'd call Brandon Rios out a million times. We got Marquez, you know, Guerrero, any guys in front of me, all these guys in front of me, I'm number 5, I'm 6. Any one of y'all guys, you know what I mean, that's before me and got a world title, fight me. It's on your ass whooping, you know what I mean? You get knocked out, you get knocked out. Hey, it is what it is. It's a fighting game. Let's go back to the old times, and when you have a guy that's in the ratings and it's number 1, whatever, you fight him, you don't duck him, don't go around him, fight him. Just like if I get to the top, and y'all right there, I give y'all the same opportunity. It's Hammer and Hank. Look, Hammer and Hank coming to a city of town, and it's Hammer Town, baby.
And I was talking to Snow, last but not least, how is the boxing community here?
Oh man, it was a big ordeal with that, you know. Joe Frazier, he paid a large weight for it, you know what I mean? So, it was like, in Philly we was hurt, you know what I mean? You could see, a lot of people came down and attended Joe Frazier's approval. You know what I mean? It was big, and it was like almost a low blow to lose one of our legends. You know what I mean? Like, Philly's a fighting town, and he was one of the legends, you know what I mean? Right there at the top. I mean, rest in peace, Jeff.
Alright, well, Play to Win ENT, Trev Munroe, you're here with Hammer and Hank. You know, a beat fighter, top fighter, you know, calling the dudes out, man, it's boxing. You know, taking it back to the sweet science, to the essence. You know, just like I say, Hank, thank you for the time, you know, and definitely gonna be checking for you.
That's
you know what I'm saying? And Play to Win and all the fans and your followers, you know, we support you, and we here, man, in the hood, out in Philly.
That's how we do it, baby. Much love.
While at the gym in Philly, I got a chance to get a glimpse at the Silver Gloves champion for the 13 and under, Rasheem Brown.
No, Rasheem Brown? When he was a glimmer in his mother's eyes. That's my nephew.
Okay.
Before he was born.
Okay. And what's your plans moving forward?
Whenever come, you know, I don't make plans for them. I just make sure they know how to fight.
Okay.
They don't have that peer pressure and stuff. They take it from there. I just guide them through.
Okay. And he's going after the championship again, right?
Yeah.
Do you want to speak on that?
Definitely.
Okay.
Yeah, he definitely won the whole thing last year. He won the first segment again already last week at our gym. He had the silver gloves at our gym. So he won this now, he's going to go out for the regionals, and then he's going to go for the state.
Okay.
And then he goes to the national.
Okay.
7 years. Okay. Who's your favorite boxer out there?
Me.
I like that answer. So what's your future goal, man? in boxing?
Being a champion.
Okay. See you doing your thing. I see you doing your thing, baby.
I'm the one who laughs now, last man standing, taking shots like a class clown. Getting it in from beginning to end, I'm driven only by hunger, that's my advantage to win. I ain't fighting fair, strike you like I'm right in here. Dancing with the devil in the ghetto, but that's life, who cares? Do what you gotta do or get the shit beat out of you. It's one on one, mano a mano, you ain't got a crew. No one to save you, nowhere to escape to. If we go 12 rounds, in your blood I'll bathe you. Give you a beating for the obvious reason that you trying to break me down while you bobbing and weaving. Tonight, if you full of fight, you got me competing. We're putting food on my table, you won't stop me from eating. I got mouths to feed, so your mouth will bleed. I'm punching like a drunk junkie that's been high off weed. I say a long prayer before I lay my head. Dude, I pay my dues, promoters better break bread. Beyond the glory is a very long story, but my life took the hard road to the bright lights. Ain't nothing nice, only God I fear. I'm still here through the years, shedding blood, sweat, and tears. Yeah, shedding blood, sweat, and tears. Through the years, all I did was shed blood, sweat, and tears. Stay doing my dips, pull-ups, couple of crunches. When I'm in the ring, I'm all out, pulling no punches. Got the stamina to handle ya, then maybe damage ya. Body shot to the ribs, right here live on camera. Bloody with a big eye, got my fam ringside. Chances of beating me is smaller than my ring size. It ain't no thing, I did my road work, feeling sore. Caught the medicine ball, standing with no shirt. Sweaty in the gym, like letting out my sins. Sweat coming through my pores, it's holy water on my skin. Preparation in the gym is where all of it begins. If I start slacking off, I won't make it to round 10. And rap's the same way, it's not beef, it's battle. It's competition for the top spot. See, I'm top notch, from the streets a hot block is where I lay my head. Going hard to the paint, promoters better break bread. I say a long prayer before I lay my head. Dude, I pay my dues, promoters better break bread. Beyond the glory is a very long story, but my life took the hard road to the bright lights. Ain't nothing nice, only God I fear. I'm still here through the years, shedding blood, sweat, and tears. Yeah, shedding blood, sweat, and tears. Through the years, all I do is shed blood, sweat, and tears. See, the sport is my love, plus my mic is my gloves. I won't break, I won't budge, I won't clinch, I won't hug. I'm a rep to my last breath, every line I write left. Never shook, don't need 8 bars to hit you with a hook. I'll break you down, dog, till I'm on top. Step around all your punches like that's all you got. See, my dedication with a lot of preparation got me going through the motion while you nervous hesitating. I'm a beast, I'm a monster, a superior boxer. These punches are too fast for you to even counter. Rhyme for rhyme, I'm Ali in his prime. You know I'm ill, blessed with Sugar Ray Robinson skill. A threat like Willie Pep, marvelous like Marvin. I'm straight out of the ghetto, most my people are starving. Got you screaming no mas like Roberto Duran. I'm Tommy Hearns with the pen, just call me the hitman. I say a long prayer before I lay my head. Dude, I pay my dues, promoters better break bread. Beyond the glory is a very long story, but my life took the hard road to the bright lights. Ain't nothing nice, only God I fear. I'm still here through the years, shedding blood, sweat, and tears. Yeah, shedding blood, sweat, and tears. Through the years, all I did was shed blood, sweat, and tears.
I saw my man last night, man. I thought he was gonna lose it the other night.
Yeah, he came back nice and strong, though. I like that.
But as far as you and me, it's just a waste of my time.
The street supports you, man.
You got all the talent in the world. Hard work, be talented, talented, don't work hard. Remember that. Remember that, man.
Because we did our lust thing, don't mean that she mine. I might check on you now and then, make sure that you.